Hey guys, it's me, Jello Pineda, your middle class sneakerhead, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to be talking about my top 5 favorite sneakers in my collection. So stay tuned! Thank you so much for checking on this video today, and I do hope you guys are having a wonderful day. And if you're new here, please make sure that you're subscribed to my YouTube channel. And of course, welcome po sa ating channel. And if matagal ka narito tol, thank you very much for sticking with me. I came up with the top 5 favorite sneakers in my collection kasi there times na, you know, that sneaker is very special to you kapag you're only using it on a special occasion. It's not every day na you get to wear your favorite sneaker. For some, talagang gusto nila everyday sinusuot nila. Ako, in my opinion, sila yung mga mas inaalagaan ko, and I only tend to wear them on special days or kung merong occasion. Hindi siya yung everyday na sinusuot ko. Basta paborito ko sila, and syempre hindi ko sila sinusuot on a regular basis. Sinusuot ko lang sila kapag, alam mo yun, kapag medyo... And I do know na kayo din meron kayong mga top 5 sneakers or top sneakers na madalang yung nasunot or special occasion yun lang silang sinusuot. So, let's get into it. My top 5 favorite sneaker in my collection would be the Ultra Boost 19. Ako nagulat ako dito sa Ultra Boost 19 kasi nung una, medyo aesthetics-wise, hindi sila kasing angas nung naunang mga Ultra Boost. However, the more na sinusuot ko siya, the more na mas lumalambot siya, the more na mas nakikita ko yung squishiness ng dati or nararamdaman ko yung squishiness ng mga dating Ultra Boost compared dito sa Ultra Boost na to. And at the same time, you know, it's an Ultra Boost 19. The colorway itself, yung multicolor siya na prime knit or prime knit 360 material, just does it for me. And at the same time, it's crazy comfortable. Ngayon, especially ngayon na I've worn this for about, I don't know, I think 10 times already. So, hindi na siya brand new. Pero, alam nun, I make sure na after ko silang sinusuot, nililinis ko sila. And as well as, it's very versatile. Although, favorite ko din naman yung iba mga Ultra Boost, aside dito sa 19. Pero for me, ang parang pinaka, kung meron man ako matitirang Ultra Boost in my collection, it would be this. And special mention ko na rin si Ultra Boost 4.0 na Oreo na kinustom ko. Now, my top 4 favorite sneaker in my collection would be the Nike React Element 87 in the blue and orange colorway. Nung ginawan ko na review to, medyo hindi ko nagustuhan yung performance niya noon. Although you can feel na sobrang squishy siya. Yung problema ko dito na matigas siya at nanunugat, nawala din siya in time. So, dahil, simply because dahil nasusuot ko na siya on a, alam yun, on a special occasion basis, at least once a month masusuot ko na talaga siya, or at least twice, it would depend. And as you can see, I already beat the hell out of this. Talagang nasusuot ko talaga siya. You can see the creases over here. Ayan. Tapos medyo ano na talaga siya. Talagang na I literally wore this already for more than 20 times already. So sobrang sulit na nito sa akin. And one reason but favorite ko siya is simply because of the upper construction. It's very unique. If you want attention to your feet, I would go with this kasi napaka-loud talaga ng colorway niya, yung orange and then yung blue. As well as the upper material just does it for me, yung translucent upper na you can change your sock game. And at the same time, it's very comfortable. Surprisingly, React cushioning, medyo ito yung parang panlaban ng Nike sa Boost. And they're doing well at it. Again, there are some things na di ko nagustuhan dito nung una, pero as time goes by, everything just changes. And at the end of the day, it became my top 4 favorite sneaker in my collection. Number 3 spot goes to the Puma RSX Reinvent. This sneaker is surprisingly comfortable for a dad shoe. Hindi siya yung dad shoe na talagang pagsuot mo, mukha kang tatay talaga. No. Alam mo yung sleeker version, although on the chunky side, pero sleek version siya ng mga dad shoe. And at the same time, the upper material is very breathable. Itong mesh niya dito, I'm very surprised na, alam mo yun, some people slept on this. And then it released recently sa Soul Academy. Originally, this wasn't released in Asia. It was only released in UK and US. I was a little hesitant kasi it's a Puma silhouette. Pero the moment that I tried them on feet, the first time that I tried them on feet, grabe iba yung feeling. It's very comfortable. Especially the sock liner, so plush, so premium. Alam mo yun, with also premium materials, we have suede, you have mesh, you have leather, you have 3M hits. And at the same time, the color itself, the Puma RSX Reinvent colorway, it's an OG colorway by the way. Sobrang lambot, even yung insole niya. Yung insole niya na parang gel something, gel insoles niya, napaka-comfortable na sneaker na to. And for, although I bought for resale, dun tayo medyo natalo. And then nag-release sila ng 6,000 plus lang dito sa Soul Academy. Pero still, alam mo yun, I was still able to grab a pair earlier. And now, the number 2 spot goes to the Yeezy Boost 350 V2. Well, aside sa ito lang ang colorway na, or ito lang ang Yeezy na meron ako ngayon, I sort of disposed yung iba kong Yeezys. Parang andito ka na sa mix ng light color siya, na nandyan pa rin yung design ng isang staple na Yeezy 350 V2. It's a blue tint, medyo bluish. Alam naman natin yung colorway na to. I've worn this a lot already and I've already made some videos on how I was able to whiten the outsole. Even if I've got for over retail, I'm still keeping this. At the same time, it's very versatile and it's very comfortable. Crazy comfortable din ang mga Yeezys. Although, makapalang ang knit uppers na mga Yeezys, we all know that these aren't performance sneakers, these are casual sneakers. Or lifestyle sneakers. And for me, you can dress them up and you can dress them down. At least hindi, I didn't end up with creams na dumihin talaga. At least ito, bluish tint. So, kung medyo madumihin siya ng slight, hindi siya ganun kahalata. Although, syempre, the bottom is yellowing as expected. That's very normal. Ganun naman talaga. This is a keeper for me. Lahat ng colorways sa lumabas, aside dun sa sesame, ito yung merong subtle pop. Yung ano lang, yung chill lang siya. Yun yung nagustuhan ko sa blue tints. So, yan. And now, my top 1 favorite sneaker in my collection, Jordan 1 Shadows. Yes, I've said it many times before. Jordan 1 Shadows is my favorite sneaker. Ito yung hinahanap kong color blocking, number 1. And then number 2, you can never go wrong with the Jordan 1 silhouette. They might not be that comfortable because this is an old technology. 1985 technology. And you can't compare it with Boost or kung ano man or React. It's hindi siya ganun ka-comfortable. Pero the things that this reminds you of when you're wearing this classic silhouette, for me, it's one of those sneakers na gusto mo nang i-keep, na hindi mo na i-resell or something. One reason but favorite ko din to is simply because the color blocking, gray and black and white. So sobrang very neutral, sobrang you can wear it on a regular basis na rin. It's a Jordan 1 classic. For me, meron man akong kikip na Jordan 1, it's gonna be this right here. And at the same time, this sneaker is very versatile. You can dress them up, you can dress them down. And again, alam naman natin na Jordan 1, the more na nagluluma siya, the more na gumaganda siya, the more na dumadagdag yung crease sa toe box, or nagkakaroon siya ng crease dito sa heel area, the more na mas gumaganda siya. The only thing na hindi ko nagugustuhan, honestly, is kapag napupudpud siya dito, nauubos itong black rubber outsole niya. Doon lang ako medyo naano ng konti, kaya inaalagaan ko pa rin naman siya. So that concludes my top 5 sneakers, or my top 5 favorite sneakers in my collection. What are your top 5 favorite sneakers in your collection? And let me know in the comment section down below. If you like this video, please go ahead and smash that like button dito sa baba. And if bago ka dito, please make sure that you're subscribed to my YouTube channel. And if matagal ka na dito tol, thank you very much for sticking with me. So yun lang. Anyways, maraming salamat for checking on this video as always. And I'll see you on the next one. Peace guys!